Hello guys, and welcome back to my channel Civil Construction and Tutor. And this is a new video series of structural dynamics, and in this video we'll try to cover some terms related to structural dynamics and earthquake engineering. So starting with the very first term, that is degree of freedom, which we have already discussed in various structural related subject like TOS 1, TOS 2 and applied mechanics. So starting with the very basic definitions, so this degree of freedom, it is simply total number of total number of independent coordinates or displacement or generalized displacements of an or in any structure or element. It is simply that if we apply a force, then the independent displacement that a structure can possess is simply a degree of freedom. Let me clear you about the degree of freedom by using a simple example of a frame system. So this is a frame system. Okay, I'll take two cases, one with the rigid beam and another with the not rigid beam. So this is the frame system with not rigid beam, and another is structure with rigid beam. The rigid beam cancels out the displacements or the moment at the intersection point. So this is the rigid beam. Now considering the displacement, so this will be the displacement for a not rigid beam. One, two, and this is the third. So degree of freedom is equal to 3, and for a not rigid beam, for a rigid beam, only one direction. So degree of freedom is equal to 1. Single degree of freedom. For this, I will use simple harmonic motion to represent the single degree of freedom. Okay, because I'll show you in the video later on. So simple harmonic motion. Why we require simple harmonic motion in structural dynamics? Then basically a structure is subjected to a force, then it oscillates for a certain time. So that should be represented by simple harmonic motion. Considering a structure of mass M, then due to its mass, it possesses some stiffness represented by K, and due to the oscillation, the energy accumulated has to be dispersed, which is done through the damping phenomenon. So it is represented as C. Now let me represent this with a simple spring mass system. Considering the structure of mass M or an element of mass M, which is placed over a smooth surface, due to its mass, it possesses some stiffness. So which is represented by a mass, by a spring system with an stiffness K and the damping force C, damping coefficient C, and will be subjected to a force PT, okay, PT, because time varying force. So this is a simple mass spring system, because a simple mass spring system represents the simplest vibratory structural system. And consider and remember that the mass is only permitted to move along the direction of spring elongation. Now let us draw the simple free bird diagram. So the structure or mass M is subjected to a force PT. Let us show the direction of force applied, PT, and considering a structure free from damping, that is C is equal to 0, the structural spring force will act in the opposite direction of the applied force. So K into the displacement, so let us represent the displacement to be VT. Now the SDOF vibration can be studied by applying Newton's second law of motion. So that typically states the unbalanced force in any structure is proportional to the structural acceleration produced, or the acceleration produced in that structure. So mass into acceleration, time dependent acceleration. Free body diagram. So if a mass M is subjected to the force PT with spring system. Then K into VT is equal to PT. That is the simple concept. But for any unbalanced force, that will be balanced by the acceleration. So VT is the initial displacement of the structure, and according to Newton's second law, any unbalanced force of any structure is balanced by the acceleration, or is proportional to the acceleration produced in that structure. So for which so simply F is equal to MA, that is the concept we have, the force. So K into VT minus PT is equal to the mass into acceleration, that is the unbalanced force. So MUT, that is, as I said, any unbalanced force will be balanced by the acceleration. So multiplying with the constant mass, we get this equation. So MUT plus KVT is equal to PT. So this is the equation for simple harmonic motion. M into acceleration plus spring coefficient into initial displacement is equal to the applied force. Now some key terms from simple harmonic motion equation, M into mass into acceleration plus spring coefficient into initial displacement is equal to force applied. For free vibration, that is, as I said, there will be no any external force acting on it. In such case, the simple harmonic equation is modified to mass into acceleration plus stiffness coefficient multiplied by the initial displacement is equal to zero, because external force applied is zero. Here no force, then how the vibration occurs? Then this is a simple question that everyone gets confused with. If there is no force, then how will the vibration occur? So basically, considering this as a structure, now if I give some initial displacement, then it will try to come back to its original position. So this is the initial displacement that I have provided. So due to the initial displacement, it vibrates or it oscillates, the structure gets vibrated. So without any force also, the structure gets some vibration. So initial displacement sets structure into the vibration. So this is a concept that we have to understand about a free vibration. So let's write down the question again. Dividing this equation by mass, we get acceleration plus stiffness coefficient by mass into displacement is equal to zero. So representing or replacing K by M, so which is basically K by M is equal to stiffness by mass is equal to omega square, which we have already discussed in physics class. So omega is equal to under root by K by M, where omega is simply angular frequency of an free vibration. So the unit is radian per second. So in equation 1, acceleration plus omega square into displacement is equal to 0, acceleration is equal to minus omega square into initial displacement. Now, types of loading. The very first is free vibration. Second is force vibration. And let us classify this. In free vibration, we have two cases, undamped and damped. And for force vibration, we have undamped and damped. And we will derive the equations for the various vibration or loading cases. So for undamped free vibration, the time dependent graph will be like this. That is, the with time the applied force remain constant and then the oscillations also remains constant. But for damped free vibration, along with time the applied force gets damped and the oscillation decays exponentially. So this is the decaying of oscillation. So for undamped case, no damping force is applied, that is C is equal to 0. So mu, that is m into acceleration plus stiffness coefficient into displacement, is equal to 0. There is no force, that is free vibration. M into acceleration plus displacement into stiffness coefficient is equal to Pt. This is forced vibration with no damping, undamped forced vibration. Now for damped case, the simple harmonic equation which we derived previously will be accompanied by a new term, that is C into velocity, that is damping constant into velocity. And for the forced vibration, it will be accompanied by applied force Pt. C is equal to damping constant, or we can also say dashpot constant. In the next video, we will discuss more on these topics, free vibration and forced vibration. Thank you.